Teaching styles are considered to be the general principles, educational and management strategies for classroom instruction. Teaching styles are also called teaching methods. What are the different types of teaching styles? What are the pros and cons of different types of teaching styles? How does the nature of teaching style change? Hello everyone, Raja here. It's my pleasure to meet you through this video. You are watching Isprit Academy. This video was specially created for our community of future ready educators. Join our community using the link given in the description. There are 5 types of teaching styles. Let me explain one by one. The authority method, also known as the lecture style, involves a sitting and listening to the instructor speak about a pre-assigned topic while the students take notes and memorize to the best of their ability what's being said. This particular style is more popular to handle a larger student population. The pure lecture method is most suitable for subjects like history, which necessitate memorization of key facts, dates, names, etc. It's a better approach for older and matured students. In lecture style, the learner only receives the information and restricted to the knowledge and understanding level of cognitive domain. Children love to interact with teachers. So it's a questionable model for teaching children because there is little or no interaction with the teachers. Instead of using only a verbal lecture to give information and teach, this style of teaching helps the teacher to coach students using gateways like multimedia presentations, class activities and demonstrations. For subjects like math, science, music, art and physical education, this style is perfect because the demonstration is usually necessary to acquire a full understanding of the subject. Do you like to be a demonstrator? Simple. Demonstrate what you teach. Let's discuss the pros and cons of this style. Teacher is able to teach at psychomotor level because learning by doing is encouraged in this style. Although it is well suited for teaching variety of subjects, it's difficult to accommodate students' individual needs in larger classrooms. Class control will be a concern in larger student population. The facilitated style tries to encourage self-learning. This style is best used in small classroom settings. Facilitators don't try to teach. Instead, they plan their lessons in such a way that students learn by themselves. This style promotes self-learning and self-discovery. Facilitators aim at developing critical thinking skills and problem-solving skills among students. This style trains students to ask questions by themselves and find the answers by themselves. Here, the learners have the freedom to choose the suitable learning tool on their own, and the learner is encouraged to think in analysis level of cognitive domain. Facilitators encourage diverse learning. Teachers find this style little challenging in terms of interacting with students and prompt them towards discovery. The delegated style is used for subjects that require group work, lab-based learning, or peer feedback. For example, science classes and language learning classes. The teacher acts as an observer to promote peer collaboration and encourage student-to-student learning. The delegated style is best suited for curricula that require lab activities such as chemistry, physics, and biology, or subjects that permit peer feedback like debate and creative writing. This style encourages students to think at evaluating and creating level, which are the highest levels of cognitive domain. The delegator encourages the students to create their own learning tools. Delegators include cognitive, affective, and psychomotor levels in the lesson plan. Considered a modern style of teaching, it's sometimes criticized as eroding teacher authority. As a delegator, the teacher acts more as a consultant rather than the traditional authority figure. Last but not the least, the hybrid method, also known as blended learning, is an integrated teaching style. In hybrid style, effective teachers use their skills, knowledge, and experience to identify the students' interests and needs and prepare teaching activities based on multiple intelligence. This style of teaching takes the interest and needs of all the students into account. Some people argue that this style weakens the learning process because the teacher tries to be all things to all students. Why can't everyone be taught the same way? Simple. Everybody learns different ideas at different times at different paces. Some people can learn something on the first try. Some might need to have hands-on experience in order to learn. For others, the teacher needs to repeat the teaching a few times to really get the hang of things. Once we understood that everybody learns differently, it became obvious that there need to be different teaching styles to accommodate different learning styles. In order to choose a right teaching style, first of all, a teacher must understand how students learn. Based on this understanding, a teacher should adopt a suitable teaching style. The most effective teachers use a combination of computer-based activities, lectures, and group problem-solving activity to cover a topic of their curriculum. Effective learning requires the use of both working memory and long-term memory. Working memory is the short-term memory. The process that takes place in my mind at this moment is considered to be working memory. Long-term memory is the storehouse of information and ideas that we know already. We can recall information at any time from long-term memory. The teaching style we choose should ensure that the newly learned concepts and skills move from working memory into long-term memory of the students. There lies the success of a teaching style. Subscribe Ispeeth Academy and share your thoughts in the comment section. If you like this video, share with your friends who are principals and teachers. I'll see you in another useful video. Until then, it's bye from Rajah.